Hello friends, in previous videos you have seen me use seedling trays to start my seeds. This really helps when one has a lot of varieties of a particular type to start, and it also saves space. However, since the last 2 years I've been using another method of starting seeds, and I've found this very easy and effective, and hence I want to share it with you because I've done it enough times to know that it works every time. I am now using 4-inch square pots to sow seeds. I fill it in with my potting mix of compost, coconut coir and vermiculite, and I moisten the potting mix very well and press it down using another pot before I sow my seeds. In each pot, I sow one variety of seeds, making holes in the already moist potting mix around 3 millimeters deep. One seed goes into each hole and then I cover the seed up and leave the tray in a shaded area till the seeds germinate, after which I move the tray to a spot that gets 2 to 3 hours sun. One does not need to keep the tray in sun for germination, and this could lead to trouble. The potting mix may dry up and the seeds may not come up. And you can see in all these 4-inch square pots, there are many plants together. There are 6 or 7 or 8 of them even, for both tomatoes and peppers. And as they grow, I will show you how I separate them out. These are Black Beauty tomato seedlings, and you can see that they are all in different stages of growth. And the reason for that is the seeds have germinated over a period of 8 to 20 days. This one is the largest one. There was another one which I have already separated and put into this cup, and it has started to send out roots. Sometimes some seeds go in deeper and some seeds, they're not that deep. Some seeds, they're very strong and they just come up very fast, and some seeds need more time to come up. So I'll show you how I'm going to separate this one, and I'll let the others grow and become bigger. So I'm going to shift this Black Beauty tomato plant into this tall cup. I have my potting mix ready. I have my label ready. And as I said in my previous video, tomato plants are very forgiving. So I'm just using this nail file to pick out this plant. If a few roots break, it is not a problem at all. Just put the soil potting mix back firmly into this one. Now I have my plant here. You can see the height. What I'll do is I will remove the lower leaves. You can just pinch them off like this. If you want, you can use a scissor or a pruner. And now we want to put this right at the base. So here it was so tall, in this cup it was tall, but here it will go right inside. So only this part of the plant will be visible. So let's go ahead. Just put a little bit of potting mix at the base so that the root is not below, and you can see the holes that have been put by heating a fork. That's it. I place the plant nicely like this in the center and start filling up. And then you have to gently press down the potting mix. There should be no air pockets, and whatever potting mix is touching the soil here, you can just gently flick it off. This is a soilless potting mix, a potting mix of cocoa peat, compost and vermiculite. You can see that video. I have discussed about 3 different types of potting mixes, and in my next video I will be comparing the soil based versus the non-soil potting mix and why I use the non-soil potting mix. So this plant is fully ready. I add the tag here so that there is no mix up. And now what is left to do is just to put a dish of water underneath and give it a drink of water. So I add the water here into this tray. I'll be putting 4 more cups because I'm going to show you how to do this one as well, in which there are 4 plants and I want to separate out all 4 of them. Now these 4, it's very easy. You just press the cup around the sides and bring out the entire root ball like this, and then you just separate it out like this. So this is 1, 2, the fourth one is a bit small, but that's fine. So you can see here, now you have 4 seedlings ready to go to the next phase. So again, I'm using yogurt pots now. Put some at the base, and this is the tallest one. Remove all the leaves from the bottom. Goes in like this, and then just fill it up with fresh potting mix. It's as simple as this. If you're growing heirlooms, please remember to label at each step. When you sow your seeds, this is the most critical phase. When you're separating them out from their cups and giving them individual cups, the labeling is most important, because you feel you'll remember, but you will never be able to remember, especially if you're growing different varieties. This is number 2. Put them in the water bath so that they can take up the water. All of the others are labeled, so I know that I have to label these. One thing to remember about these tomato plants is, once you've transplanted them and you see that half the cup is moist, you just remove it from the water bath. You don't want the potting mix to be completely wet and soggy, because that will rot the stem and then you may lose the plant, especially if you know that you're not going to get sun. We know that next 10 days we have heavy rains forecast, so once it's half moist, I'll just remove it and keep it aside. And after I'm done filming with this video, the first thing that I will do is I will label 4 of these tomato plants. That was the Black Beauty that I've labeled already. This is the Black Beauty that I had transplanted last week. It's labeled already. I had just 1 seed of this tomato variety. It's a dwarf. And I put 1 seed in this cup. It's not the tallest cup, it's half the size. And the seed came up, and now I'm not going to transplant this at all except for the final transplant. So what I do in this case, I'll just backfill the cup with fresh potting mix so that the stem is in contact with more potting mix, and it will develop roots along the way, and the new potting mix will provide more nutrients for this plant to grow. And just press it down gently. It's a potato leaf variety. And then I will bottom water it. It's more than 48 hours now since the transplant, and let me show you all the plants once more. This one is fine. See, this one is showing a little bit of leaf curling, but it should be fine. If the stem is not rotting, it will recover from this. All the others are absolutely fine. This is the Black Beauty from the big cup. It's the third day after transplant. You can see this one that was wilting yesterday. It's perked up again. So all of these are fine. So this was my second method of starting seeds to just make it a bit easier than my previous method where there were three steps and now there are two steps. Just easier to handle bigger seedlings and transplanting them. Happy growing, everyone.